Magondu A2, Isa Ahmed Luima A3, Hassan Haruna Luima A4, Habib Suleiman Njoroge A7, Selemani Hija Nyamandondo A10, and Mohammed Ali Mohammed A11, each guilty under various counts of committing the offences of terrorism and murder, where numerous persons sustained grievous bodily injuries. So where over 70 persons lost their lives and attempted murder, where numerous persons sustained grievous bodily injuries, I accordingly convicted them for each of the offences. I also found Muzaffar Luima, accused number 13, guilty of two counts of the offence of being an accessory after the fact, and accordingly convicted him. The matter has now come up for sentence. State Counsel Lino Anguzu urged court to consider imposing the ultimate sentence for the offences of terrorism and murder for which the convicts are facing sentence. He submitted that society desires peace. Hence, there is need for a sentence that would deter other members of society by making them realize that terrorism and murder are risky undertakings, as the long arm of the law always catches up with whoever indulges in them. The reasons he gave for seeking the death penalty include the gravity of the offense of terrorism and murder, the motive behind the perpetration of the crime, the brutality of the weapon used, where here the explosives had maximum impact on the victims, the effect of the offense on the victims, their families, and the entire community at large. He submitted that the commission of the crimes were premeditated, with the result that lives were lost, numerous persons sustained severe injuries leading to maiming of some, and society itself is now living in a state of fear and unnecessary inconvenience, as the state has to beef up security in all places. That is causing economic loss to the state. He pointed out that the motive for the criminal acts was both political and religious, and unless a severe sentence is imposed, society will continue to be at risk from these misguided radicals. As for Muzaffar Luima, accused number 13, counsel conceded that he has already been a remand prisoner for a period close to 6 years. And yet, on conviction, the maximum sentence that court could impose is 3 years. He thus urged court to take this into consideration. Defense counsel Caleb Alaka focused his submission on the aspect of the fact that none of the convicts is really the originator of the evil design that concluded with the train bombings, but were all brainwashed by religious fanaticism to commit the crimes for which they were found guilty and have been convicted. He therefore pleaded with the court to treat the convicts with leniency as victims of manipulation themselves. He vehemently countered the submission for the ultimate punishment and pointed out that all the convicts are in their 30s. He thus pointed out that they can still, he thus submitted. that they can still reform and be of much better use to society if given the chance to do so. I have to point out the indignation with which society views acts of terrorism in whatever form it takes. Terrorism, especially the one that is indiscriminately perpetrated by targeting innocent and non-combatant members of society, that is the soft underbelly of society, is most repugnant and cannot be justified by whatever cause, however seemingly compelling it may be. The hundreds of victims of these wanton acts had nothing to do with the decision to deploy the UPDF in Somalia. I dare say it is quite probable that amongst the victims of the bomb blast were those who were irreconcilably opposed to the deployment. And yet, because of these senseless and indiscriminate attacks, they are either dead or permanently living with the scars of these blameworthy deeds. The grave crimes of terrorism and murder, ruthlessly committed in the Chadondo rugby grounds and the Ethiopian village restaurant, must correspondingly attract severe punishments. I, however, do not believe that the death sentence would really assuage the victims and give closure to the indelible pain that society has suffered on account of the terrorist and murderous acts. In the event, with regard to each of the counts in the offenses of terrorism, murder, and attempted murder, Hussein Hassan Agade, raise your hands up. Idris Magondo, Issa Ahmed Luyima, Habib Suleiman Joroge, and Mohammed Ali Mohammed are each sentenced to life imprisonment. They will each spend the remainder of their lives in prison. In doing so, I have taken into consideration the centrality of their individual participation in these three crimes. Hassan Arona Luyima and Selemani Hija Nyamandondo shall each spend 50 years in jail for each of the counts in the offenses of terrorism, murder, and attempted murder for which they have been convicted. The sentences imposed on each of the convicts, that is all of them, the life sentence and the 50-year sentence, shall run concurrently. Muzaffar Luyima, where are you? Oh, it's down, eh?
Yes.
I'm just restating for the sake of record. Muzaffar Luyima has been in prison on remand for close to 6 years. The maximum sentence for the offense of being an accessory after the fact is 3 years. In the circumstances, I find that it does not serve the interest of justice to keep him in jail any further. Accordingly, I sentence him to community service within his area of Namasuba, in which he will serve 4 hours every 2 days of the week for 1 year. This shall be at the supervision of the LC officials of his village and the police. Accordingly then, the Registrar Criminal Division of the High Court shall within 14 days of this order summon the LC chairperson of Paraa Zone Namasuba and the DPC for the police station in charge of the area. I think it is Katwe from the evidence they gave us. Is that right? Is that Katwe? They haven't created a new one. Yes, yes. the DPC for the police station in charge of the area to serve them with this order. And on which day Muzaffar Luyema shall be released to them. Otherwise, he shall return to prison until then. So the order is that Muzaffar is not yet going to get out of prison until the day when the registrar of this court hands him over to the LC of his area in the presence of the police officer who would have been sent from the direct, from the division of police of the area to go, and he begins serving this sentence of community service. 4 hours each day, 2 days a week, for 1 year. That's the sentence.